My name is William Fabricius. I'm an associate professor of psychology at Arizona State University, and I do research on a couple of different things. Young children's social cognition, very young children's understanding of objects and space. I'd like to talk today about what I do in terms of the role of fathers in children's and adolescents' development, and in particular how that's played out into the social policy area, translating that research into social policy. So historically, child custody policy after divorce has, in effect, given children the great majority of their living time with their mothers and not their fathers after divorce, despite the fact that all of the contemporary laws say there should be no gender bias in court decisions. Nevertheless, the way it works out from a complex sort of interplay of laws and cultural beliefs, it's turned out that children of divorce, most of them have minimal time spent living with their fathers. There was really no one out there systematically getting the child's perspective on their parents' divorce. So I started a project where we asked the students at Arizona State University from divorced families for their perspectives. And what they consistently said was that they had wanted more living time with their fathers, and that they felt that equal living arrangements, equal parenting time with mom and dad, was the best arrangement for children of divorce. So these were young adults who'd lived through their parents' divorce, and this was a highly consistent perspective that they had. So when I found out this was their perspective, I began a research project in collaboration with some of the other professors here to see if that was at all true. And we looked at this in every way we could in terms of correlational research, and the findings always supported the idea that children of divorce fared best long term if they had equal parenting time with both parents. In fact, when we compared students from intact families to those from divorced families who had equal parenting time, they were pretty indistinguishable. So it appeared to perhaps wipe out the harmful effects of divorce that we see in a lot of kids. Part of that research involved looking at the long-term health, public health literature. And it turns out that equal parenting time, the most consistent effect of that is strong father-child relationships in young adulthood and strong mother-child relationships in young adulthood. And the health literature shows that relationships with parents in young adulthood predict later mental and physical stress-related health outcomes. So poor or insecure or uncertain relations with parents at young adulthood predict serious long-term physical and mental health problems, including susceptibility to infectious diseases, chronic diseases, and even early mortality, because stress causes harm on the system. So this then turned out to be a public, equal parenting time turned out to be a public health issue.